Acting as interim leader for nearly 2 years amid a troubling time for the DA, when its provincial and deputy leaders both left office under a cloud in 2021 and 2022 respectively. Summers says the party is aiming at increasing its footprint, not only in the Western Cape, but also in other key provinces ahead of the national and provincial elections next year.
The DA Western Cape is a showcase of what DA governance is, which is why we see ourselves as needing to contribute in terms of the number of votes to increase and to ensure that our national objective, as our federal leader earlier said, is to see how can we ensure that that pot of national votes increases for the party. And we do play a role already in ensuring that we build and strengthen relationships with our DA colleagues in Gauteng, with our DA colleagues in KZN. Why? To ensure that the DA difference is felt even in those provinces. So I am humbled by the trust that has been placed in me, but after walking with the party for 23 years, I think that is a clear indication of why the majority of delegates also voted for me here today. It's to ensure that now we move forward, fully understanding we have a bigger role to play beyond our boundaries as well.
Andrew Murray, Carl Popham and Zimkita Zulelo have been elected as the party's three deputy chairpersons.
For me, we must be on the ground between our citizens, and good governance is what brings people to the table. And also look at our very vulnerable areas. There's still a lot of work to do, and we can only do it when we register to vote and when we look after our people in our communities.
I want to just thank the delegates for believing in me. I have done a lot of work in the PEC in the past 3 years. So to be given another opportunity to work with young people that are going to take this DA forward, I am honestly humbled and excited because I have a lot of work that I still need to do.
The party's federal leader earlier said the upcoming election is critical for good governance and the party.
As sure as night follows day, if that coalition of corruption gets into power here in the Western Cape, the roads will start exploding like they are in Johannesburg. People will be losing their lives in building fires like they are in downtown Johannesburg. Until taps run dry and people will remain without electricity for weeks at a time without even load shedding. That's what the coalition of corruption brings. And do we want that here in the Western Cape?
The party's provincial chairperson, Jaco Londt, deputy leader, Jordan Hill-Lewis, and finance chairperson, Eric Murray, were uncontested. Grant Twigg and Xanthi Limburg were among four additional members elected. Vanessa Puna, SABC News, Cape Town.